Well, my YouTube, it's your girl Nikki Mali, and today I'll be doing a hairstyle. I mean, I'm gonna be doing some curl formers. I've been had curl formers for like years. I bought these a couple years ago. These aren't the real curl formers though. These are curl former dupes. I got them on Amazon a couple years ago for like $17. But I know the real curl formers are like $70 or something. But yeah, I'm not buying that. I always wanted to do a video doing my hair in curl formers just because, I don't know. I washed my hair, obviously. I wash my hair every day now. Ooh, my hair looks so black on camera. Like, I know my hair is black in real life, but like, beautiful black hair. I'll be using mousse and oil. Like, my hair looks cute. I feel like it's because I have makeup on. Like, this looks presentable in my head. But not, I'm lying. I wouldn't go anywhere with this. But it looks presentable for a quarantine. It's like a quarantine baddie hairstyle. Nobody's seeing you. But in real life, if I was to go to class, I would not. You would. I was like, no. Nope. But yeah, I'm gonna start. Let's see what mousse feels like. I've never used mousse in my real hair. Like, I bought this mousse so I could sculpt my wig back when I cared about my wig. I need a new wig. Because that old wig I have is just atrocious. Oh. So, I never used mousse on my real natural hair before. I love how mousse smells. Mousse just smells brand new. Like, mousse smells like I got money. Like, mousse smells good.
Alright, it doesn't make my hair feel nice.
My hair feels like poop. I mean, it doesn't feel bad, but it doesn't feel good. Yeah, it don't feel good. I'm gonna put some oil on this. Just because I want to be extra. And like, if it's like shiny, it will probably look cuter. Honestly, I really don't want to put a brush in my hair, but I'm gonna try and see how I feel. If I don't like it, then I'm gonna just stop. Yeah, I don't like combing my hair.
Alright, it's not that bad.
It's not that bad. I was overreacting. I might use a brush for my entire head, or I may not. Okay, it wasn't a bad experience, and I have no hair coming out. I mean, these lashes might be blinding me, but I don't see any hair. I don't see any hair in the brush, so that's a good thing. I forgot. Okay, so the worst thing about having cheap curl formers or fake curl formers is the comb. I forgot how much I hated this thing. So to use it, I'm doing a whole tutorial. Like, I know this gonna work out. All right, so usually I put this in like that. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah, like this. So y'all see all the curl former was like this. It's all curled up, and then you put it in, and it's like this now. And then you kind of, if you take a big section, like I'm taking a big section because I want to be finished with this thing and not in my hair for the next 5 years. I twist my roots. Oops. And then you push it up. I really hope this little thing don't just break, because usually the sad thing about having cheap stuff is that it makes it harder to work. It doesn't work. This is why you buy a real thing, guys, because the real thing would just sip through. Unlike this little cheapy cheap that just, yeah. This hairstyle is gonna take forever. And I already started late, and then the light, the sun gonna go down, and it's gonna get dark, and then I'm gonna just be like, sadness. I just wanna hit it with my hoodie on.
I feel like I need to watch a movie
while doing this so I don't get frustrated. Cause the frustration is starting to rumble. And now I remember why I stopped doing this hairstyle, because it wasn't doing hairstyle, it was a like means to stretch. Let me be silent. Like, y'all, what else? What? Okay, so my curl formers are kind of wonky because, like, I feel like the good ones, they don't look like this. But it's because I did an experiment with them one time and I put them in hot water. I know, I put plastic in hot water. I know. So they kind of got wonky after that. So some of them are like, they were harder than this before. But the only thing is that like the fake ones, like the loops that I have, they're usually harder than the real ones. And the real ones are kind of softer. So mine's kind of feel like the real ones because of my experiment. Which is not really a good thing. Because when it's kind of like harder, it kind of molds your hair easier and makes it kind of straighter kind of-ish. I wanted to talk to you guys about combing your hair.
Yeah, I know, right? Just like, wow, she's so original.
But yeah, so one thing I kind of realized is that even though we're in quarantine, a lot of people aren't combing their hair. And I feel like being in quarantine is like the perfect time to like get to explore your hair and get to see like the things you like to do. Oh my gosh, it left such a big mark. I think I always drop something on myself when doing videos, or either in my eyes or just, I don't know, I feel like I always drop something. I hope this dry is clear. If not, I'm gonna have to change my shirt. I feel like we need to just comb our hairs.
That sounds so weird. Is it grammatically correct? I need an English major right now.
Comb our hairs. Somebody tell me in the comment section if that's correct. Cause that sounds so wrong. I feel like if I was writing an essay saying comb our hairs, I would think no.
A D minus.
But anyways, I think we just need to comb our hair right now because we have the time to. There was a girl on Twitter, she was asking like what people doing with their hair during quarantine, and some people were like, they're keeping their hair in the wigs. So I'm like, why would you keep your hair in wigs during this time? Like, it's the best time to like experiment. Ain't nobody seeing you but like your close friends or close loved ones, people in your house seeing you. So it's like the best time to like experiment with hair styles and stuff. And like, if you don't use this time to experiment with your hair, like, that's really on you. Like, that's how I feel. I mean, that's on you. Don't be complaining about nothing when you be like, oh, I wonder if my hair can do that. Girl, you had a whole month to figure out if your hair could do that thing, and you really don't try. You left your hair braided up or whatever. Like, honestly, it's laziness, and I'm not even gonna act like I'm not a part of the laziness gang, because I definitely am. I normally just wash my hair and then sleek it in a sleek bun because I don't want to deal with it. But I feel like even though I'm doing a sleek bun every day, I'm washing my hair every day. I'm trying something that I always wanted to do, but my time and like my lifestyle didn't allow me to. Guys, ignore my dark elbows because my elbows are like, they're like 10 shades darker than the rest of my body, and like, we're not even gonna give them attention. Okay, we're not even gonna give them attention. We're not gonna let my elbows live rent free in our minds. I want to evict them. But anyways. Oh my god. Oh my gosh. This is a treacherous. But yeah, I'm a part of the lazy crew too. So I get it. It's like annoying to comb your hair and stuff. Cause this is, it really is annoying. It's annoying to me. I understand, sis, but we really need to just get to know our hair a little bit. Like, if you're in quarantine, don't be sitting down in quarantine with no wig on your head. So it's like, honestly, try doing a FlexiRod set or something. Y'all probably watch me and be like, girl, I'm not listening to her. Like, she looks stressed as a mall. She looks stressed. This hairstyle thing is stressing her out, and she's telling me to try it. But I honestly think, even if it's not no curl formers with no fake curl formers, because if it was the real curl formers, or if I had bought the real stick, which I had intended to buy a couple years ago, but then I stopped using curl formers, so I'm gonna do a smaller section in the back. All
I need. I just need a smaller section in the back.
Yay! And that, my friends, is how you do cross numbers. My hair should be dry. It obviously got darker because, yeah, sadly. But I want to start taking these down. Hopefully it's 100% dry because I really am tired of waiting for these things to dry. But yeah, I've been waiting for like an hour. Oh, mamma mia. This is so cute. Okay, I'm excited now. This is so cute. This is too cute, honestly. So this is what my hair looks like. I mean, it's not perfect, but this is really good. Like, what, honey? What else? I'm gonna try separating some of my hair.
So this is what happened after I separated some of my hair. It got bigger, which was good, but it also got a lot frizzier, especially in the front. The front had a whole lot of frizz, sadly.
It's
hell. It's cute. It would have turned out really. Wait, did you do it on like wet hair?
Yeah.
The front wasn't fully dried,
so that's why.
It's your girl Caleb coming at you. Go subscribe down below. You feel me? Cause my girl, she's gorgeous. She's gorgeous. It's okay.
I cheese too hard.
It's okay.
I tried.
It's really cute though. No, it's just frizzy.
Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like, leave a comment telling me what hairstyle you want to see me do next. And just don't forget to do your hair during quarantine. Bye.